The Dead Sea is a body of water found between Jordan, Israel, and Palestine. It is technically a landlocked lake, not a sea, and has been named the Dead Sea because of its total lack of plant, fish, or bird life. This is due to an exceptionally high salt content, due to it being fed by the Jordan River. But it has no outlet, meaning water can only exit by evaporating and leaving its minerals and salts behind. It is now estimated to be 9.7 times saltier than the ocean. The saltiness has been intensified by human activity as less water reaches the Dead Sea from the Jordan River due to things like dams and diversions for agriculture. As we've either redirected or prevented the flow of water, less fresh stuff is reaching the Dead Sea, meaning there's less available to dilute the salty lake. To add to that, the region's heat and mineral-rich springs sprouting along the Dead Sea shores due to tectonic activity. The Dead Sea is the second saltiest lake on the planet, topped in brininess by the Gate Ala Pond located in the Danakil Depression in Ethiopia. That pond is a staggering 43.3% salt, compared to the Dead Sea's 34%, but given the ocean is on average 3.5%, you get an idea of how incredibly salty that still is. The extreme salinity means that anybody climbing in can float with ease. Its levels have also been dropping at a rate of around 1.2 metres per year as a result of human activity. And it gets even saltier. Scientists have noticed something happening on the lake bed. The Dead Sea Observatory discovered that in response to increasing saline levels, salt has been precipitating on the lake bed, creating a salt layer that's getting thicker by several inches each year. It happens through a process known as salt fingering, in which hot water travels to comparatively cooler bottom, losing its capacity to hold salt as it cools. Instead, the salt gets dumped in crystal form. And this happens relatively quickly because the Dead Sea is already at the extreme end of how much salt can be saturated into water. The only life to be found in the Dead Sea is microscopic. As you might imagine, living things don't really vibe with this degree of salinity, and even the saltiest of extremophiles like brine shrimp aren't interested. In 1992, life put on quite a show in the Dead Sea when a bloom of Duinellia parva flushed the top layer of water that was likely diluted enough by rainwater to make it possible. Despite Duinellia parva being a green algae, the bloom turned the Dead Sea red due to high levels of bacteria rubin. So good work, the Dead Sea. Nothing will convince the planet you're still alive, quite like looking like a big puddle of salty blood. Thank you for watching, and be sure to hit that subscribe button for more science videos.